This video will explain how to classify soil using a unified soil classification system. And the system is shown here. There are two parts for this chart. We'll see that the top chart is for coarse grain soil. And for this particular chart, the difference between coarse grain soil and fine grain soil is 50%. So if we have more than 50% coarse grain soil, we're going to use top chart. If we have more than 50% of fine particles, we're going to use the bottom part. So another thing that is different from ASH, the soil classification system, is the percentage pass in sieve number 4. So in this particular case, sieve number 4 will give you the boundary between gravel and silt. So if we have more gravel, then we're gonna use this part of the chart. If we have more sand, so in this case, this is gonna be sand, and this is gonna be gravel. So you will notice that the boundary is 4.75 millimeters. And in Australian system, we use the boundary of 2.36 millimeters. So that's the difference that you should be aware of. So the rest, it's quite similar to the ASH, the soil classification system. And let's see how we can use it. And we'll start with soil 1. And we also use soil 2. These two soils are non-plastic. And we are given the coefficient of curvature and coefficient of uniformity, because at some point we will classify the soil based on its gradation. So let's start with soil 1. We'll see that we have gravel 26% and sand 72% and fines only 2%. This means that we have less than 50% that will pass through this sieve of 0.075 millimeters, which is the boundary between coarse grain soil and fine grain soil. If less than 50% passes through this boundary, it means that more than 50% is coarse grain soil, and that's why we're going to use this top part of the chart. So then we'll just see what we have more, and we see that we have more sand. So in this case, we are going to go in here. So we'll say that more than 50% passes through the boundary between gravel and silt. And then we need to find fines. So this is again percentage passing of 0.075, which means fines. And we have only 2% fines. So this means that we're going this way. And now we need to decide if this soil is well graded or poorly graded. So we are given coefficient of curvature is 1.05. And we see that it's in the range, yes. And then the coefficient of uniformity should be more than 6. And in this case, we have 10. So yes. So our answer is going to be yes. And that will give us the classification for soil number 1, which is SW. Okay. Now let's look at the second soil and see how we can classify it again using the chart. So we have gravel 26%, sand 65%, and fines 9%. So because we have less than 50% fines, again we're going to use the top part of the chart. And again we have more sand than gravel. We're still gonna go this way. This is sand. We have fines 9%, so it will fall in this range. So you will see, because it's in the range from 5 to 12%, we're going to have dual classification. And we're going to come here and we need to decide which one is the right one for our soil. And we can look at the coefficient of curvature and coefficient of uniformity. And we know that the soil is sand. We will notice that coefficient of curvature is less than 1, so it doesn't actually fall in this range, which means that the soil is poorly graded. So the symbol will be SP, and we're going to find for SP, and we're going to have this one and this one. So we don't know exactly which one is the right one because we don't have enough information about how much silt and clay is in the soil. We just know it's only 9% of fines. That's why we're going to write two answers. So SP, SM, and SP, SC. So this is the classification for soil 2. Now let's look at two plastic soils. So soil 3 and soil 4, they all have plasticity. We know that because we are given liquid limit and plastic limit for both cases. And now let's see how we can classify the soil using this unified soil classification system. Again, we need to find how much fines we have in the soil. And in this case, fines will be 27 plus 7, 34%. So it's still less than 50%. So we're going to use this part of the chart. Now, what we need to do next is we're going to find the plasticity index, and we are going to use plasticity index 26 minus 17 will give us 9%. So now we will see where it is, if it's above A line or below A line. If liquid limit is 26, it's somewhere here, and we have plasticity index 9 here. So we'll see that it's going to be clay, Cl, and it's above the A line. So for this chart, we just need to know if it's above or below A line, because we'll be asked this question. So okay, now let's see what we have and how we classify the soil. Again, we're going to use the top part of the chart. Then we'll see what we have more. And we'll see that we have more gravel. So in this case, we are going to use this part. And then we have fines of 38%. It's going to be this one. And you see, there is a question. So if plasticity index above greater than this expression. This expression stands for A line, and A line is here. So basically this question asks you, if the point on the plasticity chart above A line or below A line. We already decided that it's above A line, and we say yes. So the classification is going to be GC. So this is what we're going to write here, GC. Okay, and now let's look at soil 4. Let's see how much fines we have. In this case, we have 40%, which means that again, we're going to use the top part of the chart, and let's find plasticity index first. It's 32 minus 24 will give us 8%. And let's see if it's above or below the A line. So 32 is here and 8% is here. So it's actually below M line. It's below the A line. Okay. So now let's classify soil 4. So again, it's less than 50% fines. We come this way. Then we have more sand. So we're gonna go this way. And then next one is we have fines 40%. It's this way. And we're going to answer this question again. So if it's above or below, so in this case it's below, so we're going to say no. and the answer will be SM.